This hot summer day in New York City did not stop these protesters from showing their disappointment and disapproval of Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on the eve of his second State of the Nation address.
This state of impunity, repression, and fascism only keeps getting worse in our homeland. Just several days ago, Marcos Jr. passed the Maharlika Investment Fund, a corruption scheme that will only ensure more ill-gotten wealth for the dictator and his family. The Supreme Court of the Philippines has also dropped the ill-gotten wealth case against his father, Ferdinand Marcos, and his wife, Imelda, and their cronies.
Protesters say the passing of Maharlika Investment Fund, which they described as railroaded, the Philippine Supreme Court's dismissal of Imelda and Marcos Sr.'s ill-gotten wealth case, as well as the Philippine government's pushback against the ICC probe into Duterte's drug war, are big red flags that should not be ignored.
It just means same old, same old. It's really very frustrating because we here keep struggling and fighting.
Jane Orendine, who has been an anti-Marcos activist in New York since the late 70s, says history is repeating itself right before our eyes, and that the son is not that different from the father.
The problems faced by the Filipino people of today is a direct indication of a growing dictatorship. With soaring living costs and lowering wages, history teaches us that when your people are hungry, they will revolt. And revolt they will. When the rights of students and workers alike are threatened, our response is to take to the streets, marching side by side as we chant songs of freedom and justice, just as we did long ago.
Protesters add, Filipinos should watch the Philippine President's SONA this year with a critical mind.
I think something that we need to keep in mind is Marcos Jr. is really into rebranding dictatorship. He cares more about his image and his own political power than the issues of the Filipino people, of the workers, the peasants.
These people who are committing all these crimes against the Filipino people will not be able to get away with what they're doing.
Yeah. Right.
So, tuloy ang laban.
Protesters say it is important to fact-check the president's annual State of the Nation address and hold him accountable for his actions or inaction.
The Philippines is not for sale!
Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.